In part 7 of our lesson on applications of vectors, we will solve problems involving bearing. First, let's do a quick review of bearing. Remember that we have learned two types of bearing. The first is bearing given as a single degree measure. You start with a dotted line to the north and rotate clockwise through the given angle. So let's look at this example where the bearing from B to C is 150 degrees. We know that everything starts from B. So starting from B, we make a dotted line to the north, and then we turn through 150 degrees, and then we draw the vector out to point C. The second type is when bearing is given as direction 1, angle, direction 2. You start with a dotted line going to direction 1, then turn through the given angle towards direction 2. So in this example, the bearing from X to Y is south 42 degrees west. So starting from X, we draw a dotted line to the south, and then we turn 42 degrees towards the west, and from X, we draw the vector out to point Y. In this example, a luxury liner leaves port on a bearing of 243.0 degrees and travels 12.6 miles. So let's start off by drawing just that much. We know that the luxury liner starts at port, so let's make a point and we can call it P for port. The bearing is given as a single degree measure. That means that we start out by drawing a dotted line to the north, and then we will turn clockwise through 243 degrees. Now, if we started by looking north and we turned this far, we know that would be 90 degrees. Turning down here would mean we turned 180 degrees. Turning over here would be 270 degrees, so we know that 243 degrees will be between 180 and 270. So let's go ahead and make our vector. And we know that distance is 12.6 miles, and the angle of rotation was 243.0 degrees. So the boat started here at port and traveled 12.6 miles on a bearing of 243.0, which means now the boat is right here. Let's call this point A. Next, we're told it then turns due north and travels 3.2 miles and then stops. So remember that the luxury liner is at point A now. It's not at the port anymore. It left port, traveled the 12.6 miles, and is here now. So from here, we're going to turn due north and then travel the 3.2 miles. Now you want to be careful when you draw your vector for the 3.2 because it should be much shorter than your vector for the 12.6. In fact, it should only be roughly 1/4 as big as the 12.6. So we get our vector going to the north, and it traveled 3.2 miles. And now it's here. We can call this point B, and that is where the luxury liner stops. So we are being asked to find how far is the luxury liner from port. So we know that the luxury liner is here at point B and port is over here. So that means the distance from port is represented by that line segment. And using our naming convention, since this is angle A, we will call this opposite side lowercase a. So if we want to know how far the luxury liner is from port now, what this question is asking us to find is a. So we have the makings of a triangle here, which means we need to find an angle in there somewhere. We know that this dotted line runs north and south. If we extended it out, we know that starting from north and turning to here would be 180 degrees. Starting from north and turning all the way to this 12.6, we know was 243.0 degrees, which means we could now find this angle by doing 243 degrees minus 180 degrees, and we discover that that is 63 degrees. So now we know this angle. We still don't have an angle in our triangle, but we have a pair of parallel lines in the picture. Remember, we know this is a north-south line, and we know that this is a north-south line over here. So if you picture the 12.6 as a transversal, then that means the 63 degrees is an alternate interior angle with angle A in our triangle. So now we know that angle A is 63 degrees, and that was because parallel lines implies that the alternate interior angles are equal to each other. That's how we got that our angle A was equal to 63 degrees. Now we assess our triangle and see that we have side, angle, side. So because we have side, angle, side, we know that means we can use the law of cosines. We can find side A because A squared would equal 12.6 squared plus 3.2 squared minus 2 times 12.6 times 3.2 times the cosine of 63 degrees. So then A is going to be the square root. Well, let's find some of these values here. We can do 12.6 squared plus 3.2 squared, and that works out to be 169. We have to subtract 2 times 12.6 times 3.2, and we get 80.64 that we have to multiply times the cosine of 63 degrees. So then that means A is going to be, we have to do second square root 169 minus 80.64 times the cosine of 63. Make sure you close the parentheses for the cosine and the square root. And rounded to the tenths, we find out that A is 11.5, and its units would be in miles. So we can put that on our picture. The next question asks, what is its bearing from port? So from the perspective of being at point P, where the port is, we have to find the bearing that we'd be looking at point B. So we have to find this bearing. That is the bearing from port. Now, we know the bearing from port to the 12.6 is 243.0 degrees. If we knew what this angle in our triangle was, then we could just add that to the 243 degrees, and then we would get the bearing from port to where the luxury liner is now. So in our triangle, this is angle P. Now, remember, our triangle only has one angle in it, so if we were to use the law of sines, that would be the ambiguous case. However, because the 12.6 is much bigger than the 3.2, we know that the angle opposite the 3.2, which is angle P, will have to be smaller than the angle opposite the 12.6, which is angle B. Because angle P is smaller, we know it must be acute, because the two smaller angles in every triangle are acute. So we can go ahead and use law of sines to find angle P. We get that the sine of P divided by its opposite side, 3.2, is going to have to equal the sine of 63 degrees divided by its opposite side, which is 11.5. We cross multiply to get that sine of P is going to equal 3.2 times the sine of 63 degrees divided by 11.5. So now we have sine of P is equal to, and let's enter this into our calculators, 3.2 times the sine of 63 divided by 11.5. We get 0.2479, etc. And let's go ahead and store this in any memory location. Maybe we'll put it in A. So we hit store A. Now to solve our equation for angle P, we have to take the sine inverse of both sides. So we have the sine inverse of the left-hand side, which is sine of P, has to equal the sine inverse of that number that we just stored in memory location A, which is the 0.2479, etc. The sine inverse of the sine of P becomes P. And on the right-hand side, we get our calculators and do second sine inverse memory variable A. And we find out that angle P is equal to 14.4 degrees. Now remember, that's not our bearing. That is the angle in the triangle. So what we now know is that this angle right here is 14.4 degrees. And we said that to find the bearing, we could start from the bearing we began with, which was 243 degrees, which goes to point A, and we just have to add in that 14.4 degrees. So then the bearing from port is going to be 243.0 degrees plus 14.4 degrees, which is 257.4 degrees. So to be complete here, we could write this distance then as a sentence. The distance from port is 11.5 miles.